It's exciting to be here. We took a risk a few years ago with TED to give our brand away and to offer organizers around the world a free license to put on their own events. It kind of exploded beyond our imagination. There've been more than 2,000 events held in the last year. So the X, which originally stood for self-organized, really now stands for TED multiplied. Now we get numerous requests to do TEDx issue, you know, TEDx climate, TEDx energy, TEDx whatever. And we say no to pretty much all of them. TEDx is about local events, TEDx Boston, TEDx Kabul, TEDx Baghdad. We said yes in this case, partly because of trust in the excellent oversight of Stuart and Ryan, but partly because this is such a big deal. It's such a thrilling big deal. The chance to inaugurate something paradigm shifting, perhaps, for science overall. You know, the work of people in this room is spectacular. It's mind-boggling and deserves celebrating. And I'm thrilled it can be celebrated today. Also deserves careful pondering. There's obviously a long history of cases of unintended consequences, especially when it comes to our interface with the environment. It's true that a lot of what people here are trying to do is to reverse prior acts of Homo sapiens that created these extinctions in the first place. But perhaps worth noting that most of those prior acts were unintended, unconscious. And there seems to be a difference in the way that the public regards unconscious acts or acts of omission versus intentional acts, like, for example, releasing into the wild a restored species that might explode in numbers. So it's critical to, I think, for everyone involved in this, to really go to the nth degree to show that you have thought about this, that every imaginable precaution has been taken, that we're being wise, that we're being careful as stewardships of incredible, potent new knowledge. I've heard lots of arguments for why this is a good thing, and we'll hear lots of them today. Honestly, the language that most resonates with me is something like the following. I mean, all my life, the narrative of our relationship with nature has been one of this kind of heroic but losing battle. We win a few battles here and there. The war is being lost. Environment destruction, loss of habitat, species relentlessly clicking off the map. It's heartbreaking. It's kind of like working in mainstream media after the arrival of the internet. You know, a few things occasionally happen, but basically your life is one of sort of relentless disappointment. I'm sick of it. I'm sick of it. And under the radar, there's this other narrative out there about the possibility of forests being restored, grasslands being restored, humans being seduced by amazing new cities to pull back from their overreach on our planet. And is it just possible that our children might come to think of the world not as one of just relentlessly getting worse, but one where actually there is a chance of a richer, more beautiful future? If that's to happen, we have to sometimes play offense, not just defense. And it's going to be down to the work of people in this room. So truly, I salute your brilliance and your courage, and I wish you great patience and supreme wisdom. Good luck.